I want to thank all of you for attending this important convention and for all the members I've met across Ontario over the last 2 months. And most importantly, I am grateful for the love and support of my wife, Belinda, under attack by our prior executive. At this same convention center a year ago, I was told I was trespassing because of my advocacy from those two campaigns to axe the carbon tax and take back our PC party. Campaigns that advocated for the end of corruption in our party. In that same week, I had my party membership revoked, and the executive filed an egregious lawsuit against me, designed or we could shut down these campaigns and walk away from our party for good. Belinda said to me with a steel will that I needed to defend that lawsuit and defend our rights and the rights of people across Ontario to participate in the political process. For 5 long weeks over Christmas, I defended that lawsuit, and on Christmas Eve, the judge brought down his decision. Frivolous, without merit, no legal basis to the claim, no evidence, and he was thrown out of court. Belinda kept moving forward. She went on to challenge the nomination in Cambridge against all odds. With over 1,000 fake memberships submitted by others in the system, and only 3 weeks to campaign, and she won. And so I'm rewriting the phrase that says every man seeking to lead needs a strong woman behind him, because in my experience, if a man wants to lead, he needs to follow a strong woman like my wife, Belinda Carhalios. The attack against my family was not the only egregious incident of our prior executive. Last year, our party spent $1.3 million on downtown Toronto lawyers of your money to cover up corrupted nominations and on threats to sue party members. The prior executive thought their job was to be a messenger for Patrick Brown. They were wrong. Their job was to represent you, our members. But despite the victory in court, it wasn't until our leadership race started that I saw the light at the end of the tunnel. Our leadership candidate said our party constitution wasn't being followed, our party was in crisis, and we needed to respect our members, and they all unanimously said it was time to axe the carbon tax. Our Premier Ford ushered in his thunderous majority with his first priority to scrap the cap and trade carbon tax. This showed me the best was yet to come in our PC party. But this dramatic turnaround in our party makes it easy to forget one thing. All of the tragedies in our party over the last 3 years could have been prevented a long time ago if we had one thing, a strong party president who would have done their job, observe the adherence to our constitution and represent you, the members. That is what is at stake here. I am running to be your president because, like you, I have strong beliefs about what our party must do to move forward. I have strong beliefs about our party's governance. All of us as party members have one obligation, to uphold our party constitution. That is the mark of loyalty in our party, and it rests on our president to ensure that our executive adheres to that, and to represent you, our members, to our caucus and our premier, and to provide them sound advice, so that we can have the full confidence that our party is being governed with a higher level of integrity and accountability. As your next party president, I will lead our executive by continuing to lead by example. I will ensure that the job is fulfilled as mandated, and I will do so with passion, conviction, and courage. We will ensure that candidates are selected in accordance with our party constitution in nomination meetings, which shall be open, which shall be public, and which shall be democratic. This does not require a constitutional amendment. It is not up for debate. Over the next 2 years, we must develop a comprehensive policy process with local and regional meetings where all of you are informed and able to participate in a vote at the next convention. And none of should never miss a chance to vote in any election in our party again because you did not have access to a paper ballot. I will also take two immediate steps. We need to ban the purchase of party memberships with cash money to stop fraud in our membership system. And I will enforce the obligation of neutrality that our party staff already has by asking them to sign an oath of neutrality. In the immediate months, our executive must govern in a transparent fashion. Not as a body that imposes their views, but as a body that oversees the governance of our party and represents you, our members. This includes due process, publishing minutes of meetings, disclosing the individuals on our committees, and most importantly, ensuring that executive members do not insert themselves in internal party races. That is a good governance model for our party, and it is my vision. My critics, they say this is a revolution. They are wrong. It is not a revolution. It is just the party constitution. Now, there is a difference between my positions and my challenge. Brian Patterson has his own agenda. He has a slate of 21 people designed to take over our executive from top to bottom. There are five individuals on the slate who sat on our prior executive. There are several lobbyists for a wind turbine company, for a few marijuana companies, for a big bank. The slate released the plan 6 weeks into their campaign. It called for an end to cash memberships, a policy process, nominations, and it criticized the fact that members didn't get to vote in the leadership. Does that sound familiar? When I see my opponents come around to agreeing with me, that is proof positive that our campaign is uniting our party and moving us forward. But the question now is, who do you trust to lead our executive? 2 weeks ago, Brian promoted a grassroots policy process at this convention. 83 minutes later, he said if it was up to him, he wouldn't have had policy. On nomination 6 weeks ago, Team Patterson said that their superior knowledge of the factions of our party would allow them to broker deals when it comes to picking candidates. These two approaches do not comply with our party constitution, and they do not respect you, the members. There are as many factions in our party as there are members on any given day, and the only way to broker a deal between all of you is by giving each and every one of you and party members across Ontario the right to vote. And on disenfranchised party members, on the same day our premier announced that he was running for leader, Mr. Patterson wanted to shut down the leadership race, which would have disenfranchised every member from their right to vote for leader. Not surprisingly, Brian's been silent on my idea for an oath of neutrality. But now the slate says they are for the members. They are anything but. I have a message for the slate and their friends who believe the party constitution should only be followed some of the time, and who believe that members only get to vote when they decide. You are a small minority of our Ontario BC party, and it is high time to stop the backroom deals and get on board with our party members. It is time to move forward. It is time that we as progressive conservatives start being consistent. We believe in the rule of law. We are built on that. We believe in democracy and the right to vote. We preach that. We believe in fair voting. We uphold that around the world. This is the only sure way to unite the tens of thousands of members in our party. I challenge you all today, let's be better as a party. Now, I know some of you are thinking, that's fine, Jim, but I don't care about voting in the party constitution. I just want our party to win. What does this have to do with winning? The next election or the election after that. This has everything to do with winning. To win in 2022 and 2026 and beyond, We must ensure our party is governed in a fashion that does not end up with our great premier having to answer questions on memberships, on nominations, and about members who are denied their ability to participate in the political process. Let's be a political party that supports, that supporters are excited to come out and help, so that supporters will become members like us, and members will become volunteers who want to canvas and install lawn signs and then become donors. So that donors like you can have the full confidence that their money is being put to build for the next election and not on schemes to control our membership. So tomorrow morning, it's choice time. As your party president, I will be a voice for you, our caucus and our premier. I will fulfill this honor with passion, loyalty, and dedication. I ask for your vote as party president as a vote of conviction, a vote of courage, and a vote of conscience. Because I would be proud to represent you, our party members, and mark the next step in the new chapter of our party, one with higher integrity and accountability, so that we are stronger, more stable, and more united than ever before. After all that we have been through, now is not the time to go backwards in our Ontario PC party. It is time to keep on moving forward. Thank you very much. Thank you.